स्वच्छाकेसरिणः स्वच्छसुच्छाय आयासित इन्दवः त्रायन्ताम्बो मधुरिपोः प्रपन्नार्तिच्छिदो नखाः. वि आर् लुकिङ्ग् एट् द अङ्गिरसम् इन् महाभारत एण्ड् एस् अ कङ्क्लूषन् हि सेड् तदेवम् अनुक्रमणी निर्दिष्टेन वाक्येन भगवद्व्यतिरेकिणः सर्वस्य अन्यस्य अनित्यतां प्रकाशयत मोक्षलक्षण एव एकः परमः परः पुरुषार्थः शास्त्रनये काव्यनये च तृष्णाक्षयसुखपरिपोषलक्षणः शान्तोरसः महाभारतस्य अङ्गित्वेन विवक्षितः इति सुप्रतिपादितम्. सो शास्त्रनये अकार्डिङ्ग् टु शास्त्रिक् प्रिन्सिपल्स् इट् इस् मोक्ष दट् इस् द परमपुरुषार्थः. एण्ड् इफ् यु लुक् एट् इट् फ्रम् द काव्य पर्स्पेक्टिव् तृष्णाक्षयः सुखपरिपोषलक्षणः शान्तरसः. सो निर्वेदस्थायीभावः वेर् यु लुक् एट् द वे देर् इस् द चरितम् आफ् पाण्डवास् और् वृष्णिकुलम् एव्रिथिङ्ग् एण्डेड् इन् विरसम् फ्रम् देर् यु गेट् वैराग्यम् विच् इस् निर्वेद इन् काव्यम् फ्रम् द काव्य पर्स्पेक्टिव् इट् इस् काल्ड् निर्वेद एण्ड् ए स्थायीभाव फ्रम् देर् तृष्णाक्षयः देर् इस् अ destruction of all the desires, sukha pariposha lakshanaha, and the pinnacle of sukham is attained when we experience shantarasam. Hence shantarasa is the angirasam for Mahabharata. Atyanta sarabhutatvat, now what he is, as a continuation of this, he is trying to say, see, when he started off, there was a question that this is not said in the anukramani. Moksha parva has not been said in the anukramani, where he has said sarvadrasa sadharanam sarva purusharthanam api avideyatvam iti tatra uktam. For that, in order to, and it has not been specified that shantarasa is there or moksha rasa is there, but we have shown in various places where Vasudeva has been said and parama purushartha is moksha, right? In the same manner, rasa is best brought out only if it is not said by swashabdam. Till now he has not taken up that swashabda vachitvam in a he has taken it up in a detailed manner where he discussed the rasa and rasavad alankaram and swashabda vachitvam there. So because we are dealing with the angirasa of Mahabharatam, he just wants to give it as a conclusion, and not only in shantarasam, it can also be applicable for adbhutarasam and shringararasam. He is going to point out examples for that also. So atyanta sarabhutatvat cha ayam arthaha vyangyatvena iva darshitaha natu vachyatvena. So nowhere in Mahabharata has this been said, either shantarasa or moksha lakshanaha purusharthaha. It is swashabdena na uktaha anabideyatvat eva shobha atishayaha vartate. So atyanta sarabhutatvat, this is the most essential part of a kavyam. So ayam arthaha vyangyatvena iva darshitaha, that is why it has been shown only as a pratiyamana artham and not as the primary meaning or not as a vachyartha. Vachyatvena na sarabhutaha hi arthaha swashabda anabhideyatvena prakashitaha sutarameva shobham avahati. Sarabhutaha hi arthaha, meaning that is the essence. Sarabhutaha arthaha स्वशब्द अनभिधेयत्वेन प्रकाशितः. इफ् इट् इस् शोन् विदौट् यूसिङ्ग् द वर्ड् यु नो लैक् मोक्षः आर् नाट् मोक्षः, हियर् वि आर् लुकिङ्ग् एट् इट् फ्रम् काव्य पर्स्पेक्टिव्. सो इट् शुड् बि शान्तरसम्. सो इन्स्टेड् आफ् सेयिङ्ग् दट् शान्तरस इस् द प्रधानरसम् इन् महाभारतम्, विदौट् इवन् सेयिङ्ग् दोस् वर्ड्स्, ओन्लि देन् सुतरामेव शोभाम् आवहति. दट् इस् वेन् द काव्यम् अटेन्स् अ ग्रेट् सौन्दर्यम्. प्रसिद्धिश्च इयम् अस्ति एव विदग्ध विद्वत्परिषत्सु यत् अभिमततरं वस्तु व्यङ्ग्यत्वेन प्रकाश्यते न साक्षात् शब्दवाच्यत्वेन. लैक् दट् वेन् वि वर् ऐ थिङ्क् इट् वास् इन् काव्यप्रकाशम् और् मे बि साहित्यदर्पणकार मेन्शन्स् दट् वेर् इट् इस् यु नो आन्ध्री குச்சம் ஆர் யூனோ ஹவ் இந்த இலைமறைவு காய்மறைவும் போ எனிதிங் ஷுட் நாட் பி மென்ஷன்ட் டைரக்ட்லி இஃப் இட் இஸ் எக்ஸ்பிரஸ்ட் ஸ்ட்ரெயிட் பை வேர்ட்ஸ் இட் டசன்ட் ஹாவ் சோ மச் ஆஃப் சார்ம் அன்லைக் வென் இட் இஸ் எக்ஸ்பிரஸ்ட் எஸ் அ வியங்கியம் ஸோ பிரசித்திஹி ச இயம் இட் இஸ் வெரி பாப்புலர்லி அக்செப்டட் பை விதக்த வித்வத் பரிஷத்சு இன் இன்டெலிஜென்சியா அமங் தி இன்டெலிஜென்ட் பீப்புள் வித்வான் இட் இஸ் அக்செப்டட் யத் தட் அபிமததரம் வஸ்து தட் ஐடியா ஆர் த கான்செப்ட் விச் இஸ் த மோஸ்ட் டியர் டு அ பர்சன் இட் ஷுட் நாட் பி டிரெக்ட்லி எக்ஸ்பிரஸ்ட் தென் இட் லூசஸ் த சாம் ச வியங்கியத்வேன பிரகாஷ்யதே ந சாட்சாத் சப்த சப்த வாச்சியத்வேன தஸ்மாத் ஸ்திதமேதத் ஹென்ஸ் அங்கீபூத ரசாதி ஆஶ்ரயேண காவ்யே க்ரியமாணே He comes and connects it with that navatvam that we are discussing. That is where we started off the discussion, right? Sarva arthanam navatvam alankaranam idu bhavanam rasanam navatvam. So now he brings in that point and connects it with the prakritam. And he says, angibhuta rasadi ashrayena kavye kriyamane. When a kavyam is being made with focus towards the angibhuta rasam with the pradhana rasam in mind when a kavi creates a kavyam with the pradhana rasam in mind nava artha labha bhavati depends on what all he uses so the combination and permutation combination is innumerable so pratibha anantyat and the combinations can be so many you I may take this nayaka with this rasam so or I may take dushyanta with shakuntala in abhijnana shakuntalam may have been a shrungara rasa pradhanam there may be another person who wants to write a veera rasa pradhana so that can be an angi rasam in that kavyam that he chooses or if it is venisamharam the bhima's prowess it is a more of a veera rasa pradhanam someone can only highlight the krodha rasam and raudra rasam and talk about it as a raudra rasa pradhanam or it can just the shade itself can be changed by giving it a shrungara rasa pradhanam and say that highlighting more of Bhima and Draupadi interaction rather than any other person okay suddenly the video keeps going on and off I don't know what's happening okay so it depends on the poet for and his capability his pratibha vishesham which can give a newness to any kavyam that exists or any character that exists the way he portrays it depends on the kavi pratibha so nava artha labha angibhuta rasadi ashrayena kavye kriyamane when you are trying to make a poetry or a kavyam based on what the angirasa is navartha labha bhavati there is a newness or a freshness to that artham or freshness to the work itself bandha chaya cha mahati sampadyate chaya ityukte shobha bandha chaya shobha api mahati sampadyate there is a great beauty to that poetry yatha adbhutarasam it doesn't matter whether it is even rasavad alankara is a great poetry you don't need to discount it as saying that it is gunibhutam or anything rasavad alankaram is a more is a better form other than having upama alankara or utpreksha alankara in the shlokam even if it is a gunibhutam if it is rasaparam then it is definitely one step better than normal arthalankara shlokas so atayeva cha rasa anuguna artha vishesha upanibandham alankarantara virahe api chaya atishaya yogi lakshye drishyate the point he wants to we should mention here is alankarantara virahe api like in kavya prakasham tadadosham shabdartho analankriti punah kvapi analankriti punah kvapi he gave the example of yakkaumaraharah whereas sahitya darpanakara takes that example and says there is vibhavana or there is visheshokti here but according to mamata he says there is no sputa alankaram here and he argues for that shlokam now dvanyalokakara takes a shloka where there is no apparent alankara at all except rasam It's a very beautiful example for us to show that puna analankriti punah kvapi. So rasa anuguna artha vishesha upanibandham, a poetry which has upanibandham yatra artha visheshaha upanibadhyate, artha visheshaha grihyate, katham artha visheshaha vidyate, rasa anugunaha artha visheshaha. Any meaning that is in accordance to, or it is where the rasam gets a predominance, there chaya atishaya yogi lakshye drishyate. Those lakshya shlokas have a great beauty. Atishaya shobha vartate tatra. Okay. The shloka yatha munir jayati yogindraha mahatma kumbhasambhavaha yena ekachulake drishtau tau divyau matsya kachapo. So here two Purana Sambhavams are there. One is Kumbha Sambhavaha. He is talking about Agastya. Agastya was born from a Kumbha, from a pot, so as the progeny of Mitra and Varuna. So he is also called Maitra Varuneyaha. And Munihi Yogindraha, he is a Yogi Sattamaha. And Jayati, Jayati ityukte Sarvotkarshena Vartate. He reigns supreme. Mahatma Kumbha Sambhavaha Yogindraha Munihi Jayati. Kaha saha yena yeka chulake. Chulakam ityukte in just one cupful. Cup, you cup your hand and it's a handful of water. Like Achamaniyam. He takes the entire samudram in one handful. But in that hand, eka chulake, tau divyau matsya kachapau drishtau. He saw that divine Matsya avatara and Kachapa avatara, Kurma avatara, in his hand. Both of those avatara, both the Matsya avatara and the Kachapa Kurma avatara, were in the ocean. Right? The idea that he is trying to give here is he had taken the entire ocean in one hand. So I think Kalakeya asuras were all hiding inside the ocean, and Indra wanted to defeat them, destroy them. So he asked Agastya to just drain the ocean so that they can go and fight with the Kalakeya asuras. So he takes the entire ocean in one chulakam. So yena eka chulake. So taking that ocean in one hand is that vyangyam. Right, that is an adbhuta rasam. A muni, a yogindra, who can take the entire ocean in his one handful, is definitely an adbhuta rasapurnam only. That vengyam pratimanam is also adbhutam only. The thing is, it is kshunnam. Anandavardhana uses the word kshunnam. Kshunnam meaning punah punaha varnana nirupanadina yat pishta pishtatvat Adi Nirbhinna Swarupam. It is very commonly known to people that he took that entire ocean in the, commonly in the sense, anybody who knows the Purana Katha will know that Agastya took the entire ocean in one Achamaniya. Right? So in one stroke he took it. But you should know that Purana story. That Purana story is much more popular, but the way the poet has said that in that one handful, he saw the Divya Matsyam and the Divya Kurma Avatara. Both two of those which happened in different stages in the Yuga, in Krita Yugam itself, Matsyavatara happened immediately during the Pralaya, right? Or after the Pralaya. Kurmavataram happened much later after that. But that he saw both of those avataras at the same time shows the greatness of the poet. It's an Adbhutam. Adbhutarasam is, it's a beautiful shlokam for Adbhutarasam. But what happens here? The Adbhuta Rasam has become like a Rasavad Alankara here. Okay. Even though it is a Rasavad Alankaram, it is still more beautiful than just giving us, you know, Yena Eka Chulakai Samudram Peetam Ityukte. That is not so Chamatkarakari like the way he has expressed it in this shlokam. So Munihi Jayati Yogindraha Mahatma Kumbha Sambhavaha Yena Yeka Chulake Drishtavutav Divyav Matsya Kachapu. Vyangyam is just the Jaladhi, but प्रतीतिः जलधि ज्ञानम् एकचुलके जलधिः अस्ति इति देट् इस् आल्सो अ व्यङ्ग्यम् इट्स् नाट् सो एस् इट् इस् आल्सो चमत्कारकारी देर् इस् नो डिनैङ्ग् बट् द ரசவத அலங்கார வரதி அத்புத ரச அனுகுணம் சொல்லு.
சோ இங்க எனக்கு ஆக்சுவலி ஒண்ணு புரியல, அத்புத ரசம் இங்க பிரதானம்னு சொல்றாங்க இல்ல அத்புத ரசம் இஸ் அங்கம் டு சம் குடும்ப சம்பவ விஷய ரதி ஆர் அந்த மாதிரி?
இல்ல அத்புத ரசம் அகேன் see the vachyartham is also adbhuta
oh samudrapana adjata adbhuta rasam is angam to enna solradhu matsya kachapa darshana roopa
both are adbhuta rasam but the difference he is trying to point out here is akshunnam and kshunnam that is prasiddham vastu navam vastu samudra panam angaradhu prasiddha vastu that is something which is known that purana katha is known and there is nothing yes Agastya drank the ocean but nobody has ever described it in this manner divya matsya kachapa darshanam angaradhu vandu yarume
highlight panni
okay highlighted it before yeah that is the kavi's pratibha
ah
oh adang illa angana adbhuta adbhuta rasasya navatvamuna varrache how rasa can also gain a navatvam whether it is rasavadalankara or rasavyangyam it doesn't matter there is a navatvam there which contributes to shobha atishaya yeah rasikata irkolli varle ityado atrahi adbhuta rasa anugunam ekachulake matsya kachapa darshanam chaya atishayam pushnati సో అద్భుత రస అనుగుణం వాచ్యార్థం అద్భుత రసస్య అనుగుణం అస్తి ఇట్ ఇస్ ఎన్న సోల్రదు అది వందు ద ప ద ఇట్ ఇస్ రస అనుగుణం అద్భుత రస పరం అస్తి అప్పుడు ఎత్తుకోవడం ఇట్ ఇస్ యోగ్యం ఫర్ దట్ ఇట్ ఇస్ సపోర్టింగ్ అద్భుత రస అండ్ ఏకచులకే మత్స్య కచ్చ ప్రదర్శనం దిస్ హ్యాస్ ఎ గ్రేటర్ బ్యూటీ ఛాయా అతిశయం పుష్ణాతి తత్ర హి ఏకచులకే సకల జలధి సన్నిధానాత్ అపి దివ్య మత్స్య కర్చప దర్శనం అక్షుణ్ణత్వాత్ అద్భుత రస అనుగుణ తరం సో అద్భుత రస అనుగుణమేవ సి దిస్ ఏక మత్స్య ఏకచులకే మత్స్య కర్చప దర్శనం ఈజ్ హ్యాస్ బీన్ డిస్క్రైబ్డ్ ఇన్ సచ్ ఎ మేనర్ దట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ అద్భుత రస అనుగుణం దట్స్ దెర్ ఇస్ నో డినయింగ్ దట్ బట్ the adbhuta rasam that we have as vyangyam what is that ekachulake sakala jaladi sannidhanat the entire ocean is there in his one handful beyond that this matsyakachapa darshanam is more beautiful anuguna taram he uses the tara pratyayam and says this is much more beautiful and it contributes to adbhuta rasa even more why akshunnatvat he uses the word akshunnam akshunnam means punav kshunnam is punav puna varnana nirupanam you keep on describing it again and again pishta pishtam pishta peshanam so whatever has the arachamavi arakkirdum yeah whatever you have crushed you are again and again trying to crush the same thing so which means it is already lost its power there so there is nothing beautiful there like how you know shunyam vasagriham bala chiram jumbita that's all you're just limiting it to that point whereas when you say yatam tu param ratehe that gives a new dimension to the shringara rasam and the idea which is already there so the idea that is already there is adbhuta rasam which is sakala jaladi darshanam or sakala jaladi panam ekachulake that is something which has been treated often but this one ఏకచులకే దర్శనం మత్స్యకచ్చప దర్శనం ఇస్ అక్షుణ్ణం అండ్ ఇట్ ఇస్ అ నవం వస్తు ఇట్స్ అ న్యూ వే ఆఫ్ సేయింగ్ థింగ్స్ క్షుణ్ణం హి వస్తు లోక ప్రసిద్ధి అద్భుతమపి ఈవెన్ దో ఇట్ ఇస్ అద్భుతం ఈవెన్ దో ఇట్ ఇస్ సంథింగ్ సర్ప్రైజింగ్ నా ఆశ్చర్యకారి బికాస్ ఇట్ ఇస్ బీన్ డెల్ట్ విత్ అగైన్ అండ్ అగైన్ ఓకే నచ అక్షుణ్ణం వస్తు ఉపనిబధ్యమానం నచ అక్షుణ్ణం వస్తు ఉపనిబధ్యమానం అద్భుత రసస్యైవ అనుగుణం యావత్ రసాంతరస్యాపి ఇట్స్ నాట్ సంథింగ్ ఓన్లీ ఫర్ అద్భుత రసం అదర్ రసస్ కెన్ ఆల్సో గివ్ యూ దట్ బ్యూటీ ఇట్ దెర్ క్యాన్ బి సంథింగ్ డిఫరెంట్ ఈవెన్ ఇన్ అదర్ రసస్ இட்ஸ் கிவன் இன் பிராகிருதம். அஸ்வித்யதி ரோமாஞ்சதே வேபதே ரத்யா துலாக்ர பிரதிலக்னா ச பார்ஷ்வோ அத்யாபி சுபக தஸ்யாஹ ஏன அஸ்ய ஏனாசி அதிகதா ஏனாசி அதிகதா. The Prakritam lends to so many different readings. This is the best reading that I have found, and it is more it's easier to understand the shlokam as well as the vyangyartha here. So svidyati romanchate vepate rathya tulagra pratilagnaha saha parshvaha adyapi subhaga tasyaha yena asi atigataha. So hey subhaga, meaning of the shloka is tasyaha yena parshvena tvam atigataha asi tulagra pratilagnaha. A nayika was walking long time back. She was just walking on the road, and akasmat, tulagra means akasmat yadrichaya, you had also gone through the same path. Maybe you had crossed paths. The nayika was walking this way and you had crossed path. She had seen you, but at the same time, it was probably like a gully, you know, as a very narrow street. And the side, as she was walking and you were also walking, there was a slight a touch between the two of you. So yena parshvena tasyaha parshvena, so by the side of her you had walked, atigataha asi, you had crossed her. But how did you cross? Tulagra pratilagnaha, there was a slight, pratilagnam means touch, akasmika sparshana sparshanena tvam atigataha, you had atikrantaha asi. Saha parshvaha tasyaha parshvaha, that side of her, adyapi svidyati, it is still sweating, romanchate svedaha atra sattvika bhavaha, romanchate, she is getting romancham, goosebumps, and vepate, it is kampayuktam asti. So, or ratya tulagra pratilagnaha, that ratya is actually a small gully type of narrow road. So when you had walked past her, you had just brushed past her, and that side is still experiencing. So Smriti gives her that horripilation, that romancham, vepanam, all the kampaha, sveda, all of these are still happening for her. This is as Sakhi is coming and telling the Nayaka that she is totally into you. So after seeing you experiencing all these things, and Nayika or a Nayaka, Nayakasya Sattvika Bhavaha is very normal. Okay, paraspara rati, paraspara shrungara rasam, it is a normal thing that is described by many poets in many different ways. But this idea is very novel, that you had just brushed past her, and the side with which you went, or through which you went, that side is still experiencing that thought. Now, sometimes when you read, when you listen to certain people talk, you may not have been in that same place, but even the thought, even the smriti can give rise to goosebumps. Sometimes I feel like that when I've heard great people speak directly, and I suddenly remember that moment, something like will happen to your body. It's true, but here he is describing that is Adbhuta Rasam. What I am saying is, here it is Shringara Rasa Pradhanam. So, etat gatarthat bhavyamanat ya rasapratitihi bhavati sa tvam sprishtva svidyate ரோமாஞ்சதே வேபதே இதி ஏவம் விதாத் அர்த்தாத் பிரதியமானாத் மனாகபி நோ ஜாயதே. The வ்யங்கியார்த்தம் that we see from here is, she is very much in love with you. So, do something about it. So, whatever the idea that the பிரதியமானார்த்தம் here is, தவஸ் பர்ஷனாத் சாஸ் வித்யதி வேபதே, is more like rasam only is vyangyam here, pratiyamanam here, but the vachyartham is akasmika sparshanat sa adyapi svidyati is a new idea that he says, which is even more beautiful than the rasa pratiti, shringara rasa pratiti. நோ டவுட் தட் இஸ் தி அல்டிமேட் எய்ம், தட் இஸ் த வாச்சியார்த்த ஆஃப் த ஆர் தட் இஸ் த விவக்ஷா ஆஃப் த போயட் ஆர் தட் இஸ் த வெங்கம் தட் ஹி வாண்ட்ஸ் டு பிரிங் அவுட். எவ்ரிதிங் இஸ் ஃபைன் அண்ட் வி ஆல்சோ எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் தட், பட் வி ஸ்டில் கம் பேக் டு த வாச்சியார்த்தம் அகைன் அண்ட் அகைன் அண்ட் சே ஓ திஸ் த வே ஆஃப் சேயிங் திஸ் இஸ் மோர் பியூட்டிஃபுல். த சாத்விக பாவம் அண்ட் வியபிச்சாரி பாவ தட் இஸ் பீன் டிஸ்கிரைப்ட் ஹியர் இன் அ மோர் பியூட்டிஃபுல் மேனர். சோ ஏதத் காதார்த்தாத் பாவ்யமானாத் யா ரச பிரதீதி பவதி. பாவ்யமானாத் இத்யுக்தே வென் யூ அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் த காதார்த்தம், காதா இஸ் த ஸ்லோக, த போயிட்ரி, ஃப்ரம் த போயிட்ரி மீனிங் தேர் வில் பி அ ரச பிரதீதி. பாவ்யமானாத் பாவ்யமானம் இஸ் யூ அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் தட் மீனிங் ஆஃப் தட் காதா. வென் யூ அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் த மீனிங் ஆஃப் தட் காதா யா ரச பிரதீதி பவதி தட் ரச பிரதீதி பிரதீயமானாத் மனாகபி நோ ஜாயதே. ஏவம் விதாத் அர்த்தாத் பிரதீயமானாத் மனாகபி நோ ஜாயதே. தட் பிரதீயமானம் டஸ் நாட் கிவ் யூ சோ மச் ஆஃப் பியூட்டி. ஓ நோ நோ, ஒன் மினிட். யா ரச பிரதீதி பவதி சா ரச பிரதீதி துவாம் சிருஷ்ட்வா. ஓகே, வென் த சகி கம்ஸ் அண்ட் டெல்ஸ் த ஸ்லோகா டு த நாயகா, when the nayika understands that the nayika is in love with him, he is also going to experience that rasam. Maybe he is also interested in her. The sakhi knows this mutual interest and she has come and said this shlokam. So when she comes and says the shlokam, after the meaning of that shlokam we get a rasa pratiti. That rasa pratiti sa tvam sprishtva svidyati romanchate vepate iti evam vidhat arthat pratiyamanat managapi no jayate. That rasa pratiti no, I think I'm going in round and round. Let me take a pause here. Now it is pratiyamanat eva. Okay, now if this entire gathartham, understand the gathartha as just take out the portion of yena parshvena atigataha asi saha parshvaha adyapi svidyati, that is the vachyartham here. Okay, akasmika parshva sparshanena parshvaha adya svidyati, that is the portion that is navam vastu. If this portion, if this part had been given in a different manner, instead of sprishtva, if you had even taken it as drishtva, and if that portion had been vyangyam, then it would not have given us so much. It is not a new way of expression. That parshva gives a new color to the whole idea. அது ஏதது காதார்த்தாத் பாவ்யமானாத் யா ரச பிரதீதி சா ரச பிரதீதி துவாம் ஸ்பிருஷ்ட்வா ஸ்வித்யதி ரோமாஞ்சதி வேபதே இது ஏவம் விதாத் அர்த்தாத் பிரதீயமானாத் மனாகபி நோ ஜாயதே. டேக் ஓன்லி தட் சா துவம் துவாம் ஸ்பிருஷ்ட்வா ஆர் தாம் துவாம் திருஷ்ட்வா ஸ்வித்யதி ரோமாஞ்சதே வேபதே இத்யாதி அர்த்தஹ யதி பிரதீயமானஹ பவதி நது வாச்சியஹ யதா அஸ்ய காதாயாம் வர்த அஸ்யாம் காதாயாம் வர்த்ததே ததா ந. இஃப் இட் ஹட் பீன் பிரதீயமானம் தென் இட் வுட் நாட் ஹவ் பீன் சோ பியூட்டிஃபுல். இட் இஸ் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் திஸ் வேர்ட்ஸ் பீங் இன் த sentence itself, and it gives us a rasa pratiti which is vyangyam. That shringaram is there, that is prasiddham only. We know that the shringara rasa pratiti happens, and if that rasa, instead of that rasa pratiti, if this had been just tvam sprishtva, then it would not have been so beautiful. Because he uses the word saha parshvaha adyapi svidyati, that gives a more beautiful expression. It is a more beautiful expression than just merely saying tvam drishtva athava tvam sprishtva sa svidyati. That is not going to give you such a beautiful expression like by introducing that akasmika parshva sparshana. Bobrirda enak purinjirtu. I don't know if it is clear. Oru thara solla Kamakshi.
So in the artham em புதுசா இருக்குன்னு அவர் எக்ஸ்பிளைன் பண்றாரு ராஜா.
ஆமா, இந்த இல்ல இந்த அதாவது இஃப் இட் ஹட் பீன் எனி அதர் வே இட் வுட் நாட் ஹவ் பீன் சோ பியூட்டிஃபுல். அந்த எனி அதர் வேய கீழே வந்து எக்ஸ்பிளைன் பண்ணிருக்காரு. He has given the alternative where it would not have been beautiful. Rasapratitihi managapi no jayate, na jayate tyartaha. I will not have that rasapratiti at all.
Okay, sentence puriyadu.
Aama.
Endha rasapratiti inda sudyati romanchate endra expression nala varudho, adu vandu suppose in the saparshva adhyapi no data. அப்படியே சொல்லியிருந்தா வந்திருக்காது.
நெகட்டிவா எடுத்து
சொல்லியிருக்காரு. அதுக்கு வேற ஏதாவது காரணம் மேபி
புரிஞ்சுக்கலாம். Okay, tadevam, I hope it is clear. So generally, if the expression itself, or take that parshvaha as a clue and have it like that, instead of saying tvam drishtva, he just said parshvaha adhyapi svidyati is the clue for it to be a navambastu, and this is in Shringara Rasam. Tadevam, dvani prabheda samashrayena, yatha kavyarthanam navatvam jayate, tada pratipaditam. So dvani prabheda samashrayena, we have still not taken up gunibhutam, so we have only dealt with how in different types of dvani, like avivakshita vachya dvani or atyanta tiraskrita vachya dvani or artantra sankramitam or even asamlakshikrama dvani. Now rasa, even if it is rasavad alankaram or even in shringara rasam, the same idea, if it is presented in a different manner because of the creativity of the poet, how நவத்வம் ஜாயதே, காவ்யார்த்தானாம் நவத்வம் ஜாயதே ததா பிரதிபாதிதம் குணீபூத வ்யங்கயஸ்யாபி த்ரிபேத வ்யங்க அபேக்ஷயா யே பிரகாராஹ தத் சமாஸ்ரயேணாபி காவ்ய வஸ்தூனாம் நவத்வம் பவத்யேவ. ஈவன் இன் குணீபூத வ்யங்கம் த்ரிபேத வ்யங்க அபேக்ஷயா, வஸ்துத்வனி அலங்காரத்வனி அண்ட் ரசத்வனி, ஈவன் தோ த வாச்சியார்த்த இஸ் பெட்டர் தேன் த வியங்கார்த்த ஆர் த வாச்சியார்த்த தேர் இஸ் அ சந்தே, தேர் ஆர் எயிட் டைப்ஸ் ஆஃப் குணிபூத வியங்கம் த காவிய பிரகாஷகார சேஸ் ரைட், அசுந்தரம் அவ்யங்கியம் காக்வாக்ஷிப்தம் அண்ட் ஆல் தட். ஸோ இன் ஆல் ஆஃப் தோஸ் யூ கேன் ஹாவ் த்ரிபேதம், வஸ்துத்வனி அலங்காரத்வனி அண்ட் ரசத்வனி. So imagine the number of dvani prakaras or gunibhuta vyangya prakara that can be. Tat shramashrayena api kavya vastunam navatvam bhavatyeva, there can be a freshness to a kavyam even if even in gunibhuta vyangya. Tattu ativistarakari iti na udakhritam sahridayaihi swayam utprekshaniya, because it is ativistarakari, it will become too much, so sahridayaihi swayam utprekshaniyam, you have to look, the sahridaya has to take his own idu on it. Yeah, so next is dvanehe ittam gunibhuta vyangyasya samashrayat na kavyartha viramaha asti yadi syat pratipagunaha. Dvanehe ittam gunibhuta vyangyasya cha இத்தம், thus we have shown that in dvani, right, just like how everywhere it is pratibha which is the pradhanyam. Kavyartha viramaha na syat dvanehe itam gunibhuta vyangyasya dvanehe cha samashrayat, based on dvani and gunibhuta kavyartham, the plot of a kavyam or the meaning with which they write kavyam, kavya nirmane or kavya nirmanasya, there can be no stoppage for kavya kavyartham. People can, depending on the pratibha gunam, yadi pratibha gunah asyat tarhi kavyartha viramaha eva na asti. Someone asked me, when can you finish learning Carnatic music? It's a very, someone who is not exposed to music or any literature learning or anything, someone who has just started learning, that parent will come and ask, you know, when can I finish, when can my child finish learning? For them to understand that learning can never stop, in the same way he's trying to tell us that kavyartha viramaha eva nasti tatra, because pratibhagunaha vidyate, and anand the dvani prabedanam anantyam gunibhuta vyangyanam anantyam pratyeka kavya vishayasyapi kavyarthasyapi navibhutatvena anantyam. Think about the innumerable qualities that a poet can show in that freshness that he can bring to each poetry. So kavyartha viramaha eva na asti satsu api puratana kavi prabandheshu yadi syat pratibha gunaha tasminstu asati na kinchideva kavehe vastu asti yadi pratibha gunaha syat satsu api puratana kavi prabandheshu. Even though there are many older kavis, puratana kavi prabandheshu, puranamityeva na sadhu sarvam na japi kavyam navagityavadhyam santa pariksha anyadarad bhajante mudha paraprate aneya buddhihi. Kalidasa says this. Kalidasa is accepted as the greatest poet, and if he, when he presents his first natakam Malavikagnimitram, he says puranamityeva na sadhu sarvam. Just because a poetry is Puranam, it doesn't mean that it is good. Na sadhu sarvam. Na chapi kavyam navamiti avadhyam. You should not reject a poem because it is new. Na chapi kavyam navamityavad. Santaf pariksha anyataratu badante. An intelligent person or a rasika, sahrudaya, will carefully analyze both the Puratana Kavyam and the Nautana Kavyam, and Anyataratu Bhajate. He will say this is better or that is better. He will accept one or the other. Mudaha, a fool, will be led by another fool. So Mudaha, Paraprateya Neya Buddhi. Paraprateya, Paragnyanena Neya Buddhi Tasya. Mudasya. He will not use his own intelligence for analyzing what is good and what is bad. There are so many scholars who still say Kalidasa is the best. Except Kalidasa is the best. But there are so many greater Mahakavi who have come and written poetry after that. So you can't just discount. So Satsu api puratana kavi prabandheshu. Even today there are people who are writing Mahakavims. Yadisyat pratibha gunaha. Tasminstu asati, if there is no pratibha guna, na kinchidapi kavehe vastu asti. Tasminstu, if that ananti bhuta pratibha gunam na asti chet, na kinchidapi vastu asti. So, sarvam kim idanim varnyam yatra kavehe varnana vyaparaha syat. ननु यद्यपि वर्ण्यम् अपूर्वम् नास्ति तथापि उक्ति परिपाक गुम्फ घटनादि अपर पर्याय बंध छाया. वन मिनट, लेट मी टेक दैट दैट लोचनम इज सो ब्यूटिफुल इन दिस. सी न किंचिदपि तस्मिन् अस्ति तस्मिन् न किञ्चिदपि तस्मिन्स्तु असति. इफ् दट् प्रतिभागुणम् इस् एब्सेण्ट् इन् अ कवि न किञ्चिदपि वस्तु सर्वं हि पुराणकविना एव स्पृष्टम् इति किमिदानीं वर्ण्यम्. वाट् डु ऐ हेव् टु यु नो इफ् इट् इस् पुराणकविना वाल्मीकि हेस् सेड् एव्रिथिङ्ग् सो वाट् एम् ऐ गोयिङ्ग् टु से एनिथिङ्ग् न्यू अबौट् रामायणं. बट् देर् केम् अ बहुभूति हू कुड् गिव् अस् उत्तररामचरितम् आर् महावीरचरितं विच् गिव्स् अ टोटलि डिफरेण्ट् कलर् टु बोत् सीता एण्ड् राम. That is not how Valmiki has approached. Or even for that matter, Vyasa had written the whole thing. And if in Veni Samharam, the Bhima's tying of Draupadi's hair with the blood of Duryodhana, if Vattanarayana had not come up with that plot, if he had just said, Purana Kavina Sarvameva Sprishtam Kim Idanim Varnyam Iti Yadi Saha Punarapi Na Varnyate Chete Sakavya Vastu, then it is, we would not have such a good work like Veni Samhara. Yatra Kavehe Varnana Vyaparaha Syat. ननु यद्यपि वर्ण्यम् अपूर्वं नास्ति ईवन् दो यु आर् ओन्ली टेकिङ्ग् द प्लाट् फ्रम् ऐदर् अ पुराणम् आर् इन् इतिहास आर् संथिङ्ग् दट् इस् देर् इन् द वर्ल्ड् एनी अदर् काव्यम् एनी अदर् लाङ्ग्वेज् तथापि उक्तिपरिपाकगुम्फघटनादि उक्ति इस् उक्तिवैचित्र्यं परिपाकं द it may have been just a small plot if you take Shakuntala and Dushyanta. It is a very small plot in Padma Puranam, and in fact Dushyanta has been portrayed as a very bad person there. He forgets Shakuntala, not bad in the sense he is he has a relationship with her, he leaves her in the forest and he goes to his kingdom and he forgets about her, whereas Kalidasa has just exemplified that personality and given him as a model personality for everybody today. Today we quote dialogues of Dushyanta and say that he is the most noble personality. That is only because of Kalidasa's portrayal, not because of the Purana Katha. That is Paripakam. He changes the tone. What are the stories that he brings in? Gumpanam. Todukkaradhun peru. Endha kadhaiya edoda serthu todukkaradhun peru. Just like, you know, making a garland. Gumpanam. Ghatana. All incidents that he may just introduce a new incident. That Durvasa Shapa is a new incident for Kalidasa. Right? Kavehe gumpa gumpa ghatanadi apara paryaya bandachaya navanava bhavishyati. There are so many new things that can come about. Yan niveshane kavyantaranam sambrambaha iti ashankyaha. No. If we try to introduce newer elements, what will happen to other kavyam? No, it is just a bandachaya. It improves that bandachaya. Bandachaya api arthadvaya anurupa shab. बन्धच्छाया अपि अर्थद्वय अनुरूप स्टाप् विस् ऐल् टेक् दिस् कारिका अगेन् नेक्स्ट् क्लास् ओके.